These were the good old days, pre-COVID-19, at food processing plants in America, at least relatively speaking. These lower-paying jobs have never been easy.
The workers have to process at least 122 chickens per minute. The workers will be standing shoulder to shoulder. The workers pretty much act like machines.
Magali Likoli strives to ensure the rights of poultry workers in Arkansas.
Many of them have to wear diapers because they are not allowed or not granted enough bathroom breaks.
Now, difficult work has often become downright dangerous. More than 10,000 coronavirus infections have been tied to more than 170 processing plants in the U.S.
They signed up for a job to, you know, process meat or protein for this country, but they didn't sign up to die.
At least 45 workers have died of COVID-19, including 7 at this JBS plant in Greeley, Colorado.
It's not too late for those employees, but it's too late for my dad. My dad's gone, and nothing's going to bring him back.
Likoli says plants like one in her area were very late in providing their employees personal protective equipment and establishing social distancing measures.
So really, the company was not really taking care of the workers. It was not their priority.
Testing of workers for the virus has been sporadic, she says. Paid sick time is lacking, and information about the number of positive cases often isn't shared.
I think sometimes they've been portrayed as being uncaring, but that absolutely has been not the case.
Industry expert Keith Belk says meatpacking companies simply don't have the tools to identify infected workers who are symptom-free.
The ultimate opportunity to control it would be to not allow it into the plant to begin with. And that's just really difficult to do right now. Without really, you know, rapid testing capabilities.
The outbreaks have forced dozens of plants to shut down temporarily, and that's led to meat shortages at some supermarkets. And that prompted President Trump to recently order all of those facilities to reopen.
That really is the key to making sure that food ends up on the grocery store shelves, is taking care of our team members.
Says the head of Tyson Foods, which has deep cleaned plants and installed physical barriers between employees, among other things.
I think they're all learning on the fly here as we go.
The company keeps saying, like, we're improving, but we do not have so much time.
This pandemic has put some of the country's most essential and invisible workers in the spotlight. Will the protections they've been given, some say belatedly, be enough to prevent more pain for them and their communities? Hendrik Sybrandy, CGTN, Denver.